محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I want to start by saying congratulations to all of you. And you'll be surprised that with this is my response to the issue that have taken place earlier with this person from Al Bayt. Though it was something that have upsetted you, I am saying congratulations because this is, for me, the way I see it, is a sign that Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed you with an awakened conscience. Because there are so many people who have no conscience at all. Their conscience is dead. As a matter of the fact, I was saying after Salat al-Fajr today, Allah Azza wa Jal have made an oath by a nafs al-lawwama. The nafs that constantly, question itself. And this is the nafs that Abu Bakr had. And this is the nafs that Umar radiallahu anha had. And maybe Sister Sarah knows better than me that guilt is a defense mechanism that Allah Azza wa Jal have built in our mind so that we are always re-evaluating things. If Allah forbid we do wrong things and we don't feel guilty about it, then eventually no one would stop doing wrong. You know, the story of the guy, of the person who killed 99 souls and complete them with 100. Allah Azza wa Jalla at the end of the story accepted his forgiveness, accepted him and sent him to Al-Jannah. Why he was, eager to change his life, the conscience was high. So when you had this argument and you were feeling awkward, that for me is a good sign, a healthy sign. Now, as for why did this happen, we're a human being. Allah, the Prophet ﷺ said, by Allah, if you do not do wrong and repent to Allah, then Allah will take you away and replace you with others who would do wrong and repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. As a matter of the fact, the ones whom Allah described in the Quran as being muttaqeen and have prepared for them jannatul arduha as-samawat wal-ard, a paradise that as wide as the skies and the earth, from their description, and we're talking about muttaqeen, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَ. Who speaks Arabic here? What's fahisha? Unspeakable. The unspeakable, right? So Allah describes the muttaqeen who will be awarded with Jannah, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ whenever they do a fahisha, unspeakable mistake or sin, and they immediately wake up to their own conscience and repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah will accept their tawbah. Now, does that make sense? So right now, you are fitting in the category of the muttaqeen, whom Allah Azza wa Jal has prepared a jannah that as wide as the skies and the earth. Now, there is another incident that, come to my mind, in which Ammar ibn Yasir, and Ammar ibn Yasir, by the way, is one of the Sahaba that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a special attention to, because both of his parents were killed in front of him while they were being tortured by the kuffar. His mother is, as a matter of the fact, was the first shahida in Islam. Ammar was being tortured on the blazing desert of Mecca, and they got to in one of the days to him until he was hallucinating. And they forced him to say the kufr word and to curse the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So after they let him go, he went back to his own conscience and say, what did I do? And he started crying and slapping his face. And they took him to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, this is what happened to him. This is what happened to me. So what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say to him? He said to him, وَكَيْفَ قَلْبُكَ? How is your heart? Ya Rasulullah, my heart is full of iman. Then he said, if they were to come back again and to force you to say the word of kufr, never mind it. And Allah has documented this in the Quran, in Surah Al-Nahl, إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ مَنْ شَرَحَ بِالْكُفْرِ صَدْرًا. Allah is trying to tell us, it's not about the words, It's not about the slight mistakes that once in a while we do. It's about what you are, you know, fully indoctrinated to do in your life. There are people who have a lifestyle full of ma'asi, sins. They're unable to see what they are doing wrong. Those are the one who needs to be concerned. But for the others who, you know, are struggling and walking on thin line, as Umar al-Khattab described the taqwa, it is walking in a, you know, between, you know, bushes with thorns, and you collect your thawb and try to protect yourself from being hurt. So, alhamdulillah that you have this high conscience. Now, this altercation happened with this woman. Fine. You know, it happened because you were frustrated. It happened because, yani, we haven't slept properly. You know, I'm speaking to you and my sleeping, you know, gauge is below the red. Dr. Shams, may Allah bless him, was telling me you need the sugar. I have been eating a lot of sweets lately and it's not my habit. He said, because you're burning a lot of sugar. So let's be mindful that we are engaged in a beautiful ibadah. I know Al-Hajj al-Mabrur is the Hajj that does not have vain talk. But inshallah, by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, the conscience you are demonstrating is a clear sign that inshallah your Hajj is accepted. Because, you know, وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيَّةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُوهَا. When you do something wrong, because we are sinners by nature, if you do something good immediately, it would be immediately erased. So here is what I recommend for all of you. For us to ensure that inshallah our Hajj will be mabrur, let us inshallah, based on your own ability, collect whatever we are able to and send it to the children of Gaza. And say this is our kafara to the shortcomings we have done here in this Hajj, and a way to say to Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Rabbi, we're concerned about making our Hajj 100% and perfect out of vain talk. We are also, Ya Rabbi, demonstrating to you how much we are serious about gaining your approval and acceptance to us, Ya Rabbi. And we are so conscious about what's happening to our children, our sisters, our elders in Gaza. Therefore, Ya Rabbi, we want to just send this, you know, sadaqah to them as a token of saying that this is the minimum we are able to do beside all the du'as we have done to them throughout all the circumstances and locations of the du'a being accepted throughout this trip. Remember what I said at the beginning of this trip? I personally came feeling guilty that how can I come to Hajj and spend money when my brothers and sisters in Falastin are being killed? But we need to do the fara'id. My intention was to come and pray to Allah Azza wa Jal in the places where the du'a is accepted and say, Allahumma ya mujri as-sahab, wa ya munzil al-kitab, wa ya hazim al-ahzab, عليك بجموع الكفر فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا جبار. اللهم عليك بأحزاب الكفر فإنهم قد عاثوا في الأرض الفساد فصب عليهم من عندك صوت عذاب. اللهم آمين. See, with these feelings, alhamdulillah, you are in good shape. Yes, indeed, we're human being. We will be doing, you know, a few things that are inappropriate. Yes, we will go back, inshallah, with high conscience. As days elapses and go by, we will be doing a few things here and there. But let's remember, whenever we do something that is not appropriate, immediately erase it, compensate it with a good hasan. Whether it is a sadaqah, whether it is salatul duha, whether it is, you know, something that, you know, would be, you know, something that, you know, would make you feel that you have done, yani, something that will erase this sayya. So alhamdulillah, once again, to conclude, inshallah, an incident happened. This is what I would recommend for you. The next time you see this sister walking by, look at her face and say, Assalamu alaikum, sister. We are sorry. We were not in our mood that moment. Please forgive us. Let her feel that those who come from North America are not what they think about us. We are, alhamdulillah, conscience people. May Allah send likes it from all of you, Rabbi Allahumma Ameen.
Yes. I want to say sorry. I don't know her.
Regardless of her reaction, because the you know, ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حنيم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. So يعني we do our share, you reach out to her, she responded positively, alhamdulillah. She did not, at least you did your share.
How did I find her? I want to know where she...
خلص. At least you did your tawbah. By the way, do we really have to fix every sayyah we make? No. There will be times when we say something that is not appropriate about a person. So do we say, oh, I backbited that person, I need to go back and seek the forgiveness from that person? No, don't do it. Because if you do it, you cause more damage. So repent between you and Allah Azza wa Jal and khalas, rectify it. So the same thing, if you happen by any chance to meet her in the you know, hallway, Assalamu alaikum sister, with a smile, and that's about it. Let her feel that there is nothing wrong between the two of you. Yes, she was not in a mood, you were not in a mood, altercation happened, it's done deal, it's history, now we're still sisters for the sake of Allah. May Allah Jal accept from you, Rabbi. خلاص. ماشي الحال. I understand انه الحمد لله. والله لو لم تذنبون لذهب الله بكم وجاء بقوم يذنبون ويستغفرون. She probably was having a rough day. She was having a rough day and she blew up on you. إن شاء الله يا أختي نسأل الله أن نتقبلها منكم كاملة بإذن الله ونسأل الله إن شاء الله أن يكتب لكم المغفرة والعفقة من النيران ويكتب لكم رفقة النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونسأل الله عز وجل من كرمه وجوده ومنه أن يمن علينا بحج نختتمه بزيارة المسجد النبوي والمسجد الأقصى آمنين مطمئنين فإنه على كل شيء قدير. Let's stay focused. This little thing that happened should not distract us from being focused on the bigger goal. Gain the forgiveness of Allah عز وجل, the salvation from the hellfire, and the dua to our brothers and sisters in Palestine. We are, as an ummah right now, going through a very difficult and critical situation. We need to, you know, stay awakened. We need to stay alert and then stay focused. يعني we cannot just play, the, you know, play as we are not aware or we do not know what's happening. I'm glued to Al Jazeera day and morning, trying to know what's happening there. This is our responsibility. This is our deal. يعني إن شاء الله may Allah accept from all of us يا ربي اللهم آمين. يعني I'm not sure if you I did it here or not, but I was talking in, when I was talking about dua and how إن شاء الله your dua will be يعني reached يعني heard by Allah and can it make a huge difference into your family. When Allah Azza wa Jal heard the dua of Hamna, the mother of Maryam, Allah rewarded Maryam with three things. What are they? فتقبلها ربها بقبول حسن وأنبتها نباتا حسنا وكفلها زكريا. As a result of the consciousness of the mother of Maryam, Maryam was awarded with these three things. The first one, تقبلها ربها. Allah accepted her with a beautiful acceptance. وأنبتها نباتا حسنا, provided for her the beautiful environment, the healthy environment, and he assigned to look after her one of his own prophets, Zakaria. And as a result of that, Zakaria, the teacher, was inspired by his own student. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أن لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء. One of the تفسير is that sometimes Maryam will tell her teacher Zakaria things about the deen he was amazed of. And he would say to her, how did you know this? She would say, this is from Allah. Hunalika, at that particular moment, da'a Zakariya Rabbah. What does this mean? It means whenever you feel your heart broken, whenever you feel guilty for something you have done, and you want to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal and turn to Him, know that your dua at this particular moment is accepted. That's why Zakariya immediately, Hunalika da'a Zakariya Rabbahu Rabbi habli min ladunka durriyatan tayyibah. The Malaika immediately responded to him and spoke to him while he was in the mihram. You will do that inshallah in this trip. You never know, maybe the Malaika was listening to your dua. Maybe inshallah from now until we get back home, there will be moment of reflection, there will be moment of submission in which you feel that your dua is guaranteed. I heard stories about people who, while they were around the Kaaba making the dua, they felt the Malaika coming down to them. They felt the presence of the Malaika. This could happen to any person. This is not, we're talking about the time of the Prophet and the Sahaba. Things could happen anytime. May Allah accept it from all of you, Rabbi. Yes. Yeah. Right. إن شاء الله نعم. يعني أنا حابب كمان إن الأمور الفقهية نستشير فيها الدكتور عمار. بس أنا يعني متأكد إنه الظروف إحنا وضعنا فيها was out of our own control. والمينيمم is for us يعني أنت تتكلم عن منى ولا عن مزدلفة؟ منى. يعني هي كانت أول ليلة بس اللي تأخرنا فيها إحنا. لما جيتوا متأخرين شوية. ايوه. Again. ما هي دي This is Hajj. This is Hajj. I was telling the brothers in one of the years. Now, did you see it when it rained outside? It was heavy. I remember in one of that, you know, one of the years, literally we were swimming, not walking in the water. In a very short time, a huge amount of water fall in and flooded everything. At that, you know, day, we could not do jamarat. So we had to do the fidya. You know, sadaqah, sorry, not fidya. We paid sadaqah and that's it. So there are things sometimes happen out of your control. Allah is not aware that we are here and we're doing hajj. He's aware. But He wants also us to feel a different يعني, way of submission in ibadat. He wants us to feel what's it like right now when it rains in Gaza. He wants us to know how is it for the people of Sudan or the people of Kashmir as they're going through hardships and difficulties in their life. We are going out of our traditional way and comfort zone so that we're able to feel what is it like for others who are not in the same position and comfort we're living in. No. Inshallah, bidni lajal ma fi shay. No. So any other things inshallah that you have?
Yeah. Not related, but the air conditioning, it's very hot in the day, but then at night it becomes like very cold. Is there a way for us to control it or no?
I can answer that. The people in the gray vests come in with the remote, but they won't give us the remote.
Yeah.
But
if, we have three
remotes. And so it's like 22, they go 22 and 16.
Yeah.
So the
at night 16 or like the...
No, it has to go to 22. It has to go to 22 and I can find...